guys, it's Carl Brown from guitarlessons365.com. Got a beautiful song from Bon Jovi today. We're gonna learn how to play I'll Be There For You. This one's just great, brings back some memories here. We're gonna have a lot of fun kind of cranking into all the chords. You can do a very simplified version of it, or you can also do all the fills that Richie Sambora is doing, which really kind of makes the song to me. So I'll be covering all those as well, including his solo note for note. So hope you guys will follow along. Now, before I get into it, please subscribe to the channel if you have not already. Ring the notification bell so you know it's a new video. You can like and comment, really helps the video get sent out to other people who are actually already subscribed to my stuff, but don't get it because YouTube wants to make sure they really want to see this one, I guess. So let's make it happen. And if you really want to support what I do here on YouTube, please click the link in the description below. You'll see a link to my Guitar Academy. It's a GL365 Academy. It contains all of my guitar courses, from complete courses for beginners to more advanced courses on technique, improvisation, ear training, theory, and guitar tone. I'm live there with just Academy members, like a live stream every Saturday. So you get kind of personalized support like that for me, and it's a lot of fun. So I hope you're coming over there and join the community. All right, free 7-day trial by clicking that link below. All right, so let's click here. Oh, no, let's not click here. Let's just actually start here with this little intro here, which is obviously on like a sitar type deal or a guitarist. Sounds like a sitar. So this melody, we'll talk about the bass notes in a second. Let's just get the melody down first. This on the G string. So we're gonna start from the 5th fret here on the G. So we're just gonna pick that, slide up to 7, and then pick it again. And then pick the 7th up to, slide up to 9. And then pick that and slide up to 12. And then 12 down to 11 with that kind of pull off. So with this. I'm gonna kind of do that again. And then the second time, kind of picks it, a little bit of rhythm on that last note, on the note at the 12th fret, and just resolve it down to 11. So now he has bass notes underneath that, so you'll probably see him play it live when he's gonna. So he's just kind of going. Going back and hitting the open D string in between them. But you'll hear on the recording as well, there's also an A in there, so the 5th is in there as well. So when I play this, I like to hit. So I'm hitting, instead of just the open D, I'm hitting the open D and the A in there as well. So if you listen to the track. So that's kind of how I like to personally do it, just kind of feel it sound. Obviously, it's not played on a normal guitar, so you kind of have to just make do, and I think that's the coolest way to do it. Just let the, just hit the open A and D in between each one of those melody notes. All right, so after you've done that twice, we're gonna get to the actual verse. So we have John Bon Jovi's playing just kind of simple chords, acoustic. So if you just want to do a simple version of this without all the fills, it's a pretty easy song. It's just an E minor. Well, I'll get to what Richie does in a second, like what I played in the intro, but if you just want to do what John's doing, it's just E minor to a G. So there's a little lead up into that G. A little bass line that moves into it. So it's just 0-2 on the low E and then into that G. So it starts on an E minor. So I kind of just do those 3 notes and get to that G and then fill in the rest of the notes. And then it takes it to a D major chord. So that's most of what the verse is just E minor, G, D. Go to A, not D, the last one. Got wrapped up in the vocal melody. It was just beautiful. Anyway, instead of that last time, instead of going to the D, it goes to an A major chord. So how does it go? To the A. God, you give me one more chance, girl. So it's basically E minor, G to D, until the very last time, instead of going to that D, it just goes to the A right before the chorus. All right, so now let's take a look at what Richie's doing. So he's got a little bit of a crunch tone on it, a little bit of hair on it, and he has some delay. So I've got a little bit of delay on this and a little bit of a hall reverb, which makes that stuff kind of sustain a little bit. All right, so let's start here. We're gonna just kind of the open E string, and then these harmonics at the 12th fret across the G, B, and the high E. And then here's a little bit of vibrato, just gonna add a little bit of shimmer to it. And he leads into that G as well, just like on the rhythm part of it. Now, you really don't need the full chord here. He doesn't really kind of strum it too much. He just goes. But you can, if you just have like one guitar, it's kind of good to kind of fill it in. And just kind of lightly strum that G after you get to that 0-2-3. And then you can quickly go and just hit a quick little D. Just to kind of the bottom half of a D, like to make it a D power chord. You don't have to hit the high E string or anything. It kind of sounds dumb if you do. So just like that. And then we have our first fill. So that's here on the, it's a double stops on the D and the G string. So you're gonna pick the seventh fret on the D and the G together. And then slide them up to 9. And then pick 9, the 2 9s, move them back down to 7. And then you can do this with one finger if you want. And then we're gonna come over to the 7th fret off the A and the D string. And that's kind of like, you're gonna pick that, slide up to 9, and then do it again. Kind of sliding up to the 9 twice from the 7s. And then he kind of resolves it and puts it like that. It's a D power chord. It's a 5th fret on the A, 7th on the D and the G. So far we have this. That's my broken heart. So then it goes to this. All right, so we're back to the low E open, and the harmonics now are the 7th fret across the D, G, and the B. So those three harmonics, once again with a little vibrato bar, and back to the G, a little move up into the G, and then you can hit the D real quick again, and then it's a different fill that ends it. So that's gonna be kind of quickly sliding into or just playing the 10th fret double stops off the B and the high E. And then you're gonna come same double stops down at the 5th fret on the B and the high E. And you're gonna pick those and slide to 7, back down to 5, and then back to slide back to 7, let them ring. All right, and then it starts the verse again with a low open E. So that's pretty cool. So it's an open E, And we're back to those original harmonics, so the 12th fret on the G, B, and high E. With some vibrato bar, and then back to the... And then we have this kind of Hendrix-y thing. So... So that's gonna start... gonna hammer 7 to 9 on the D. Then over to 7 on the G. And then you're gonna hold the 7th fret on the G and the 8th fret there on the B together. So with this. After that, then take these two notes together. And what he does, he's gonna pick the B and the G string together, that 8th fret there on the B, 7th on the G. And quickly hammer on the 9th fret there, the G. And then go back to the 7 and the 8. So with this. And then he does a slide from 7 to 9 on the A string into a double stop at the 7th fret across the D and the G. So with this. And then he's gonna jump up here. So more double stops on the B and the high E. So this is at the 10th fret across the B and the high E. And you pick those, slide up to 12, and back down to 10. And then jump down to the 5th fret. And you're gonna pick it twice before you slide it up and back down. And then pick it again and slide up to the 7th fret. So wait this. And then the last time through it, we go back to the open E, but then we finish it up with some harmonics and a little bit of a hybrid pick thing, looks like this. All right, so that's gonna be the open E again. And then we go into these harmonics, which really jump around a lot. Now, when you see him do this live, he doesn't do the harmonics the exact way they're on the recording. When you see the official video, he doesn't. You hear the harmonics because they're just obviously it's over the original recording, but it's not in the same where he's playing. It's not where they're actually on the recording. So the hands aren't going to match. Let me just say that because he's not doing the same thing. So I'm doing the same thing that's on the recording, which is going to be this. So that's the first set of harmonics. There's some more in the second verse. So we're going to have the ones of the second verse are different. So after you hit this, you're gonna play the 7th fret harmonic over the B, G, and D. And then it really skips around pretty quick. It goes to the harmonic at the 12th fret there on the B, and then the 5th fret there on the G. And then back to the 12th fret. The D, the 12th fret harmonic on the D string and the A. So with this. It goes to that G again, and then it goes to A. Remember the A at the end of the verse? Well, over that A, we have him doing, which is just some sixths. So we're gonna slide into the 14th fret there on the D string, and then you can hybrid pick this. I'm hybrid picking it, so the pick is getting everything on the D string, and my middle finger is getting everything on the B. But at the end, we hit them both at the same time. It's obviously got to be a hybrid pick, but or something like that. But it's going to be slide into 14 on the D, and then add the 14 on the B. And then 12 on the D, 12 on the B. Then 11 on the D, 10 on the B string. Back to those 12s. And then back to 14. And hit them both together. All right, and then it goes from there, it goes to the chorus there. So the chorus is pretty easy. I'll do it, it's on distortion a lot, but it's just kind of like this. Thank you. So this is just a D major chord. And then we're gonna have a little, there's a little bass line that takes us down, a little bass note, that fourth fret there, you can reach up and grab on the fifth fret there. I mean, I'm sorry, on the A string, fourth fret. And then to a B minor chord. So a B minor chord is a bar at the second fret across from the high E string to the A string. And then in front of it, you're gonna put the third fret there on the B, the fourth fret there on the G, and then the fourth fret there on the D. So. Then we do the same run into the G that we did in the verse, or John Bon Jovi did in the verse. And from there we go to an A major chord. You can play that like that or just bar it. And then we have these two chords that are the end of the verse, or where it goes to repeat. And I think what Richie's doing is he's playing power chords versions of it. So a power chord of the C, which is just the third fret there on the A, fifth on the D, and the G. You do that, and then move everything up one string, so it's off the third fret of the low E string. So I think Richie's doing that, but John is playing just a C to G there. So we just kind of pour the power chord version. And then. So after the first chorus, we get back into the little sitar thing. It just does it one time, and then it goes back into the verse again. So the verse is the same for John here. So nothing new there, but Richie has a different set of fills and harmonics, a little bit shorter than the first verse. So it looks like this. So from there, it actually goes to a pre-chorus, which didn't happen before the first chorus. So this one's a little bit different here. So we have it's shorter. We start with the E, low E string. Those same harmonics across the 12th fret, the G, B, and the E. And then, so we get to this G chord down here, and then he goes. So that's the open high E string with the third fret there on the B. And you're gonna pick those two notes together and immediately slide that note on the B string up to the fifth fret and then back down to the third. So it. Then it gets to the D chord and over the D. So more kind of hybrid picking. But this time it's across the G and the high E. So it's the 11th fret there on the G, and then the 10th fret there on the high E. And then you're gonna move up to this 12th fret there on the G, and the 12th fret on the high E. Then up to the 14th on the G, and 14th on the high E. And then back down to the 2 12s. And then the back to the 10 on the high E, 11 on the G, just kind of picked together. So we have this so far at the beginning of the second verse. And then we get to the harmonics. So I keep grabbing the wrong G here at the end of the second. Sounds like he does more of those Hendrix-y Gs at the end of the second verse. We'll get to that in a second. So the harmonics, though. So they're different. So the open E, this is the harmonics in the second verse. It kind of rakes into it. So this one doesn't come out as well as the other ones because he's raking into it. But the notes are going to be the harmonic of the fifth fret on the high E and the seven on the high E. So 5-7 on the high E. Then the harmonics of the 5-7 on the G. Then we're going to play the seventh fret there harmonic on the B. And then jump up here to the 12th fret. And to the 12th fret harmonic in the G and the B. So we have this. A little bit slower. And then into the G. Now, when you get to the G, sounds like he kind of does that. So if you do the 0, 2, 3 in the low E, jump over here and just grab this the G chord. You're borrowing the second fret, I'm sorry, the third fret across the B and the high E. And then the fourth fret there on the G, fifth fret there on the D string. And you're gonna add the bass there, the root note, that G with your thumb. So that one sounds a little bit different when it gets to that chord. And then it goes to the A, and they kind of sustain on this A, and he kind of sounds like, he kind of makes it like an A major, and picks up the note on the B string to make it the open B, to make it a sus, too. And then we get back to the second fret there, regular A. And then we get to the pre-chorus. So it's kind of the first pre-chorus we've had. I'll get it back to the clean setting, so we have this for the pre-chorus. So that's the first instance of the pre-chorus happens after the second verse. That's a G major chord. To an A. So. Then it goes to a D major chord. And then a, really it's kind of a D major 7 sus 2. C sharp in the bass. So it's kind of third inversion. So you can look at it that way. You can just look at this as the passing tone and don't worry about it. So it's just going to be the D major chord at first. And then what you're going to do is you're going to add that fourth fret there on the A string in the bass. But when you do that, you're going to pick up the note on the high E string. So that's the fourth fret there on the A string, and I'm playing the second fret there on the G, third fret there on the B. So just, so it kind of helps to just reach that note on the A string when you just lift up that note on the high E. It helps you get there. And then it goes from there, it goes to a B minor chord. That same B minor we did earlier. Kind of hold that a little bit, then down to the G. Together for the pre-chorus. You can lead into that G. Any of the G's you can just lead into. It gets to the same chorus that we did earlier in the song, and then it gets to the solo. So the solo, real quickly, is just kind of over really an abbreviated version of the chorus. So it's just that the D to B minor to G to A, but it doesn't have that ending on it when it's when Richie's playing over it in the chorus. So it's just the D, A minor. And then G. A. And repeat that. Cool how they started doing that pre-chorus a little bit later. It's almost like a bridge, and they do it coming out of the solo as well too, and it's actually a really nice part. So anyway, enough of that. Let's do a solo. So I'm gonna play Richie's solo for you real quick, and then I'll show you how to play it. So here we go. So I'm kind of using the same thing that I was using for the just his rhythm parts, all the fills. It's just kind of like an amp. Amp, a little bit of breakup, that's about it. And anyway, so we're gonna start here with this first phrase. So that's gonna start with an oblique bend. So what that is when you have one note that's bending while the other one's, you're playing two notes and one of them is bending and one of them is staying the same. So the note we're gonna keep stationary is that the 10th fret there on the B, and you're gonna be playing the 9th fret there on the G. Play those together. And then you're gonna be bending up that note on the G string up a whole step. And then. So I'm gonna do that oblique bend, pick it again, release the bend, pull off to the 7th fret there on the G string, over to 9 on the D, back to that 7 on the G, and play 9-7 on the D. So with this. All right, so that's the first one, and then the second one's kind of similar, except it's just timed a little bit differently. We're gonna do that oblique bend, but not for as long the second time. And we have a little different ending. We can still do a release the bend, pull off to 7, and still over to 9 on the D, but then we're gonna go back 7-9 on the G. So we have this. So all together, both of them together. All right, then we have this. Alright, so this starts out with just. He's gonna slide from 7 to 9 on the D, and it ends up being the two double stops that he goes to after that on the D and the G, hitting those a couple times. But the first time, you just hear really the note on the D string, the 7th fret there on the D. So kind of, you basically do that lick 3 times. But the first time, really just kind of bring out the note on the D string the first time, and then both the notes of the double stop the second and third time. Then we have this. So that's gonna be, after the double stops, after that, we're gonna go 7-9-7 on the G. So after 7-9-7, you're gonna do a whole step bend at the 9th fret there on the G string. And then you're gonna play 7 on the B, roll over to 7 on the high E. Into a bend at the 10th fret there on the B. Like that, I think. So after that bend there at the 10th fret, then you're gonna do another bend and release there at the 10. Down to 7 on the B string. And then the same thing here, bend and release at the 9th fret there on the G, down to 7, and then play 9-7 on the D. So all together, we have this. All All right, and then we get to some octaves, really nice little melodies. All right, so that's gonna start here at this, so this octave shape is gonna be the 7th fret there on the A, and then the 9th fret there on the G. So you really gotta make sure your index finger is really muting all the strings. So it's playing that note on the 7th fret of the A string, but you can see that the tip of it is muting, it's touching the bottom of the low E. So it's muting that string out. And then it's also muting every string under it. So I'm muting the D, G, B, and high E. Of course, then I can add a note in front of that, and it's not gonna be affected by the mute. That's the 9th fret there on the G. So it's really those two notes. The note at the 7th fret on the A, and then that 9th fret there on the G. And I can hit all the strings, and that's all you're gonna hear, because of all the muting that the index finger is doing. So that's how you want to, if you're not used to octave shapes, that's how you're gonna mute all those strings. So you can just, and you can kind of really kind of dig into the strings and do the melody, and everything's, you're just hearing those two strings that you want to be heard, and they're separated too, so it's kind of awkward at first. So we have this, so the melody though is going to go 7, so I'm calling out the note, the fret that the index finger's at. So take the same octave shape each time, from 7, slide up to 9, back down to 7, and then down to 5. So, and then it goes, the second time through, we're gonna go, still that 7, 9, 7, but instead of going down to 5, it goes up to 10. Sort of this. From there, kind of go back down, pick that 10, slide down 1 fret to the 9th fret, and then pick it again and slide down 2 frets to the 7th. To kind of start the melody over. So we have this. And then kind of start again. Now this last time, instead of going down, going from 10, 9 to 7, so the second time through, instead of playing the 7, he goes 10, 9, and takes it all the way down to the 2nd fret. So all together for this, octave section. All right, and then we get to the end of the solo, so this. So that's gonna start here with this little, that's really bluesy here. We're gonna start with a bend at the 10th fret there on the B. And then go to the 7th fret on the high E string. And then play 10-7 on the B. And then we're gonna do a bend and release at the 9th fret there on the G. Pull off to 7. So this. So starting with that 10th fret bend. And then we're gonna go, which is gonna be the 9th fret there on the D, roll over to the 9th fret there on the G, back to the 9th fret there on the D, to the 7th fret on the G. All right, from there, he kind of goes, you don't really kind of hear all those notes that he's kind of going to. He's kind of doing this really kind of a lick like that. So he kind of starts with a bend at the 9th fret. Release, pull off to 7, and then play kind of hammer on 9 on the D string, pull off 7, and the same thing on the A. And then kind of do that twice. And from there, we're this kind of. So that's kind of a bend at the 9th fret there on the G. Over to the 7th fret a couple times on the B. Into that 10th fret bend on the B. Back down to the 7, and then gonna end the solo with a bend and release at the 9th on the G. Pull off to 7, and then back to that 9. Try this. And that takes us to the pre-chorus again. Same pre-chorus as before. Same chorus as before. Now, I will say, there's little melody lines going, especially in that pre-chorus. You hear, both. But I think they're really being done by the keys. I don't really see them playing it live. But it's kind of like... So there is a kind of doing that in there, and even in the chorus. So I think that it's the keys doing that though, but you can add that in if you want to. The one during the chorus is just pretty easy. You kind of strum the chord. And then just go 2-0 on the high E string to the 3rd fret on the B. You do that kind of pretty much on every chord. And then to the A. And then in the pre-chorus, if you wanted those little, add those lines. Over the G chord, you hit the G and then just go 3-2-3 on the G. And then over the A, it's gonna be 2 on the B, open, and back to there, to the 2. So and then here, don't have to worry about here. But when you get to the B, B minor, it's still gonna be 3-2-3 of the B. This is optional, by the way. And then, same thing on the G, 3-2-3 in the B. To the ending A there. All right, so I just want to bring that up. I know you probably might hear some little moving lines in there. I think they're really done on the keys or like overdubbed guitars, probably both. If you want to bring it out, that's kind of how you do it. Those are the melody notes for the verse and pre-chorus. But they're just kind of strumming it live. They don't really do that. All right, so then it goes through the pre-chorus and the chorus. There after the solo, and then we get to the chorus. The ending chorus modulates up a whole step from D major to E major. So when it does that, we have these chords now. Like he did in the solo, comes back in, similar to it, not exactly like it, basically a whole step higher, so basically 2 frets higher. So let's look at these chords first. So we're just gonna start with an E major chord. And then we're gonna go to a C sharp minor chord. So that's just like the B minor, but up 2 frets. Now from there, we're gonna go to the A major chord. And then we're gonna go up to a B major chord. So that's just the 2nd fret there, the A, and then barring the 4th fret across the D, G, and the B. You can play it like that, you can play it like that. I like to play it with my pinky. You can play it like that. However you feel comfortable. And then we're gonna go up to the same, instead of going, C to G is gonna be D to A. So everything 2 frets higher, really, so. And then those chords continue while that little octave thing starts. So it's the same melody that we did before. But here at the starting of the seventh fret, you're gonna start at the ninth. So do everything two frets higher. So, because we're up in E now, we're in a different key. So that's just that seven, that 9, 11, 9, 7. And then 9, 11, 9, 12. So. And then back, just like we did before. So here he does it three times, and then he puts a different ending on it. So we have this. Now this different ending, so the third time, instead of going down to 9, it goes down to 6. And then back up to 9, and then we start over. Last time, after that 9, it's gonna resolve back down to 7 when the sitar thing comes back in. Now the sitar thing is different at the end because we're in a different key now. So it's gonna be an E. So the melody itself now is gonna be at the third fret, also gonna be on the B string. So we'll start at the third fret, slide from 3 to 5. I pick that 5 again. I'll talk about the in between note in a second. So 3 to 5, pick that again, then 5 to 7, and then 7 to 10, and then 10, pull off to 9 or slide down. So let's just kind of repeat that. So then up top. So in between that, come back and hit the open E, low E string. I'm doing it clean. And that'd be it. I hope you guys enjoyed it. It's a great song. Just a beautiful piece of music, and it's got some really cool stuff in it and some great guitar fills by Richie Sambora. So hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you again soon for guitar lessons365.com.